Good morning all. I welcome you all in the series of Stitching Theory and Logic Design. Myself Shilpa Sharma from EC department. And today we will discuss about the serial and parallel adders. What are serial and parallel adders? Why they are used? As we have discussed already about the basic of any adder. So, connecting them in a proper way will generate or fulfill our need to work as a serial or parallel adder. Serial adder are what? Whenever adders are connected or gives an output by giving the input in serial. And parallel adders are what? Which gives an output instantly, means immediately whenever we change the input. So it will be known as parallel adders. So in this context, first we talk about the serial adder. What are serial adders and why are they used? Serial adder is a binary adder, that is capable of forming sum and carry outputs for addend and augment words of greater than one bit in length. Means the input should be more than one bit. Like we need to add two inputs, so it has to be more than one bit. Means it needs to add the numbers who are greater than one bit in length. This is the block diagram of a serial adder. See, in this block diagram, you can see I'm using a full adder as well as D flip-flop. D flip-flop we will discuss later on, but for or to understand this serial adder, we just need to basic work of D flip-flop. We need to know. D flip-flop is something which gives an output according to input. And what's the change? Means output. What output will we will get? Whatever is the input, the output will be same if clock pulse is high. Means to get to obtain same output as of input, we need to give the clocks. So whenever clock comes, output will be changed according to input in a similar way, in a proportionate way. Okay. So, and here A and B both are added with third input and sum is generated. And what about the carry? The carry is sent to the input of D flip-flop and the output will be fed back to the input of this full adder. So this full adder will work in loop because of D flip-flop. This D flip-flop is nothing but a flip-flop which gives an output of 0 whenever we give input 0 at the input clock equals 1. So whenever clock comes, output will get changed. Here another input reset is connected. This is used to reset the block diagram block instantaneously or instantly. Clear? So this is the way a serial adder can be implemented. Now notice the difference between serial and parallel adder, which is better. So here parallel adder is faster because whenever we change the input, we need not to add bits one by one, it will add it in parallel, simultaneously it will be added, so it will be faster. And serial adder in comparison to it will be slow. The parallel adder uses registers with parallel load capacity because parallelly inputs need to be changed if it is parallel adder. Whereas in serial adder, we only use shift registers. In parallel adder, number of full adder circuit is equal to number of bits. Means for each bit to be added, we need a full adder. Whereas serial adder requires only one full adder circuit. We have seen already. And parallel adder is basically a combinational circuit, whereas serial adder will be a sequential circuit because I am using here sequential component, which is D flip-flop. Flip-flops are sequential circuits. That's why serial adder is a sequential circuit, whereas parallel adder is combinational circuit. The parallel adder, in the parallel adder, time required doesn't depend on the number of bits, whereas the in serial adder, time required for addition depends on number of bits. Now let's talk about the parallel adder. What are parallel adder? You have understand now. A parallel adder is a digital circuit that produces the arithmetic sum of two binary numbers in parallel. Okay, so the numbers have to be parallel, but they should be binary also. So this is the main requirement. Now, what is the structure of parallel adder? Parallel adder is nothing but a cascade of several full adders. So number of full adders used will depend on the number of bits in the binary digits which require to be added. Now the ripple carry adder. This is a part of parallel adder. Ripple carry adder means carry propagate adder, then carry look at adder, then many more. Carry save adders are there. So what are ripple carry adder? A binary parallel adder constructed this way is also called ripple carry adder, as the carry output of each full adder is connected to the carry input of next higher order stage. See, you can see here. C output is given as the input of A0, B0 means first full adder, and carry 1 will be generated. This carry 1 will be input to the full adder circuit number 2. Then the output generated means carry output generated from full adder 2 will be given as an input to the full adder 3. This is what ripple carry adder works. This is also known as carry propagate adder. So what is the problem in carry propagate adder? Carry propagate delay is the main disadvantage of carry propagate adder. The sum and the output carry of any stage cannot be produced until the input carry occurs. So this causes a time delay, which is called a carry propagate delay. The carry propagation delay for each full adder is the time from the application of input carry. While the output carry occurs, assuming that the A and B inputs are already present. So this is what carry propagation delay. Now, because the propagation delay will affect the output signal on different time, so the signals are given through, means given enough time to get the precious and stable outputs. The most widely used technique employs the principle of carry look at adder. I have told you, to improve the speed of the algorithm. This is what through which we can improve the speed. Here a half adder circuit diagram is used. This is the circuit diagram of full adder in which two half adders are used. Here AI and BI will be given as an input to the half adder, first half adder, and both the inputs are given to the second half adder. Now for carry look at adder, PI will be A XOR BI, and generated output will be what? AI dot BI. So the output finally sum will be according to diagram. In this, SI will be your PI XOR CI, and CI plus 1 is your GI plus PI CI. Here GI is what? Carry generate. and pi as well carry propagate. So this is the final Boolean expression for C0, C1, C2 and C3 which is generated with the help of C1, C2 and C0. Here you have seen that though C0 is using the C1, C2 and C3, it is generated directly. So directly we can avoid two losses. Here the logic diagram of query look at adder generator is drawn here. Here C3 is propagated at the same time as C2 and C1. Here many gates are used. In spite of preparing this typical diagram, a block diagram can also be drawn in which just we need to show the output of C1, C2, C3 through the help of XOR gate, and we need to replace this elaborated diagram with a block diagram. So it will look like this. Here the delay time of AND bit CLAA will be what? XOR plus AND or plus XOR. So delay time will be what? First gate plus second NAND gate, or sorry, second is your gate which we have not used. Here delay time of AND bit carry look at adder will be calculated according to the carry. Here C4 is the output final carry sum, and S3, S2, S1, S0 will be your XOR outputs. Now if we talk about carry save adder, just I have discussed you, we will discuss about carry look at adder plus carry save adder. So in context to carry save adder, what are carry save adder? Carry save adder, you can use a carry save adder to add 3 AND bit operands A0, A1 and A2 without performing any carry operations. So to perform it, we first need to calculate C plus A equals A0, A1, A2. Z is what? S1 plus means Z is actually A0 plus A1 plus A2, where A0, A1, A2 are the input lines. So you can also add one more AND bit operator. You can also add one AND bit operand to an AND bit carry save operand. So CS out will be your A plus CI, which is input. So result is in carry save forward. Parallel arranger. These are used also at parallel arrangers. Multiple operand carry save adder is also the possibility. So here array or tree arrangement can be used to define the carry save adder. This is what we have talked about for today. It's over. In the coming videos we will discuss more. Thank you.